So it's come to my attention that I've not yet introduced you to the residents of Hedgehog's Hollow as we approach hibernation at the end of 2020. And so, ladies and gentlemen, if you would allow me to introduce you to Stan and Ollie, the residents of Hedgehog's Hollow. Hello, welcome to Hedgehog's Hollow. My name is Mike, and today you're going to just have to imagine, unfortunately, that Hedgehog's Hollow is the land at the bottom of my garden. The British weather being what it is has forced me indoors today, but that hasn't changed what we're going to cover, and that's hedgehogs, attracting them to your garden and caring for them once they are there. And if that sounds like it's something you'd be interested in and you've not yet subscribed, then do consider subscribing to the channel. And don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you get notified every time a new video is published. So if you've been following the channel for a while, you'll know that we've been through a couple of phases of preparing Hedgehog's Hollow for this very moment in time, getting it ready for not just the visiting of the hedgehogs, but actually their hibernation. And so over the last few weeks and months, we've had a process of adding a new hedgehog box to the garden. We've cleaned out the boxes that we've had, we've prepared them and placed them. We've put in a feeding station to get the neighbor's cat to get away from the food and provide food for the hedgehogs, who are all coming to this point now of needing to hibernate and getting ready for that hibernation. And so I wanted to introduce you to the residents of Hedgehog's Hollow as they prepare for their hibernation and take up residence in the houses that we have prepared for them. First, allow me to introduce you to Stan. You'll notice Stan is distinctive because he appears to be blind in the right eye. That right eye simply does not reflect on camera in the same way that his left eye does. We first met Stan in the garden in the middle of October, and it was a very brief, fleeting visit. He made a beeline to the feeding station before scurrying away along the hedge and once more under the gate. But by the end of October, he had taken up residence in Hedgehog's Hollow. He had taken up occupation in the new house that had been prepared, and here you can see his regular routine. Waking up after 9 in the evening, getting up, investigating, sniffing the air, and generally heading straight for the feeding station and an evening snack. Now, Stan seemed to be quite an elderly gentleman. He didn't spend much time out of the house, and every evening, after just a few minutes having visited the feeding station, he was back into the house and slept for a couple of hours before waking up later in the morning. And then there was Ollie. Much like Stan, having visited the garden on a couple of occasions, Ollie very quickly made himself at home. But the one odd thing was that both Stan and Ollie moved into the same house. Now, this isn't exactly common with hedgehogs, but at the same time, it's not unusual. Now, it's fair to say that hedgehogs generally are solitary animals, but we have seen them share the same house before. In fact, last winter, we had up to 3 sharing the same house at the same time. So it's not unusual, and very quickly Stan and Ollie got into an evening routine. So Ollie would always be the first to wake up. Early in the evening, usually around 7:30 or 8 in the evening, Ollie would get up and be through the feeding station, through past the water bowl, and have made his way around the garden even before Stan had contemplated waking up. And this was the evening routine for quite a few days. And we got quite used to them being in this routine. Stan spent a lot more time in the house during the evening, sleeping, kind of giving me the feeling that he was the elder statesman of the pair. But then something really odd happened. And on the 8th of November, this was the last time we saw Stan. Seemingly for reasons known only to Stan the Hedgehog, he woke up and headed out the garden, and sadly, he never returned. Now, at first, Ollie didn't appear to notice Stan's absence, but one morning, a few days later, he set about filling up the void that Stan's departure had left. For about 40 to 50 minutes, Ollie set about filling up the house with anything that he could find around the garden. He started around 5:45, first with the hay that was in front of the second house just next door, and once he had gone through that supply, he then set about finding any amount of leaves and other material lying around in the flower bed that he could put into the house. I'll drop a link in the description of this video or in the card on screen at the moment, where you can have a look both at setting up this house and get an idea of exactly how large the volume is within this hedgehog house, as well as the video about cleaning the hedgehog houses. And within that video, you can see just exactly how full the hedgehogs can fill these houses with all the material that they can find. And certainly on this morning, Ollie was preparing his house for hibernation and getting it really snug and cozy. To date, at the time of recording this video, Stan has not returned to the garden. So we assume that he has found a house elsewhere in the neighborhood somewhere, and hopefully he has settled down for his hibernation. Ollie continues to be resident in our newest hedgehog house, and we look forward to having him hibernate with us over this forthcoming winter. Until next time then, from myself, Mike, and Ollie, and Hedgehogs Hollow, take care. Bye-bye.